Hey, this is Red Band coming to you live from the world famous comedy store for a brand new episode of Kill Tony Volume 4.
Yeah.
Give it up for Tony Hinchcliffe.
Hi, everybody. Hi. It's like a real live show. I'm excited about this. Merry Christmas, everyone. Make some noise. Yeah, some real noise. Brian Redband's here.
What's up?
Everybody's here, except for like a lot of people are not here.
Yeah.
Ryan J. Ebelt's not here. Maybe he's drawing this episode from live. We're live streaming right now.
Yeah.
So what's up, everybody? Merry Christmas. That's cool. Jamie Vernon on the HD camera. Yeah. He showed me virtual reality the other day.
God, isn't it awesome?
I killed zombies 360 degrees just shooting zombies. It was fucking unbelievable.
Wait till you do the porn. It's completely...
Oh, there's some of that wacky Brian humor. That's the first joke of the night.
It's legit.
There you go.
It's an upgrade in porn.
Wait till you do the porn.
The next mag. You know how it was like magazine, then
creepy.
VHS.
All right, that's enough. So what do you guys think? Should we... What do you... Bring up the guests?
Well, we should talk about where we're at.
Oh, yeah. We're doing this show that you're at, ladies and gentlemen, in its home club. This is episode 189. You're watching it here. It's the number one live comedy podcast in the world at the Comedy Store on a Monday. It's a lot of fun. So much so that we get to do the best comedy festivals in the country. We're doing Sketchfest in San Francisco, January 20-something. Yeah. We're also doing Moon Tower this year in Austin, Texas, which is a big deal. But that's not until June or something. November 2000.
Yeah, we're doing... 420, we're going to be at that one, the Moon Tower Festival.
Yep. Yeah, that's right. And we're doing Sketchfest January 21st. That's a really big deal. San Francisco. So for those of you listening to the podcast, San Francisco, January 21st, if you're near that area. Live audience, sorry we have to do that. But like I said earlier, this is the number one live comedy podcast in the world, and other people are listening to it other places. So, all right.
More people.
Just not going to break at that at all, huh? Many more people than are in this room. No. Enjoy this show. You just so happen to be rotating guinea pigs that come in and out. You mean less than nothing to us. You understand? Just to let you know what I really think of you. Just kidding. I'm glad you guys are here. We're going to have fun tonight. You guys excited? Let's bring out our guests.
Yeah.
We got to just do that. I think we should just do plugs in your part. Where like you're like, hey, welcome to Death Squad. When you do that like normal calm guy thing.
Don't you hate that voice?
Oh, I hate it.
It's the worst.
Hey, thanks for listening to another episode of Kill Tony. Just want to tell you some of the cool things we have going on. I listened the other day. It lasted like 3 minutes.
It's
of you
awful.
Just like, I also have a new T-shirt.
That's right.
I'm
wearing it right
now. 10 T-shirts. I know, I'm excited about it. I just got a new one.
Yeah.
All right, so let's fucking do it. We're going to have fun. As always, I have two of the funniest comedians in the world is my guess. That never changes. So put your hands together for two of my favorites. It's Steve Simone and Jason Tebow. Two guys with brand new comedy albums. Steve's just came out. Jason's comes out January, second week of January.
January 14th.
I fucking love it. Welcome to the show, guys. You guys
Hi,
have
guys.
Both done it before. I'm excited about this. The lights seem to be pointed a fun way, a little bit different or something than
right.
usual.
I'm cool with it.
Welcome back. Merry Christmas. Did you guys do anything fun for Christmas?
I saw Star Wars.
How was that? Good, right?
Everyone said it was so great that I had it up here, and then I was like, it was okay, so... I would say it's okay, and then you'll go love it. I'll say it's okay, and then you go love it.
Yeah.
If everyone said it was okay, I would have loved it.
Ooh, there you go.
Did
There's
you like it
something.
Better than the last one?
So it's just good.
Did you?
I haven't seen it.
Oh, that surprises me. I liked it better than the last one.
Oh, well, then that's pretty good.
Yeah. B minus. There it is. B minus, Star Wars. Suck it.
Have you seen it, Steve?
Not yet, no.
This is an interesting one because they're not really shoving it down everybody's throats that there's a new Star Wars. They're taking like a different approach to this. They're just sort of like, there's a new Star Wars out.
Is there
maybe you'll go see it. Maybe you won't. Like, we don't really care. We're just Disney. Just don't. We're not going to. It's like the J.J. Abrams one. They're like, maybe.
There is a baby Jar Jar Binks in it. Is what
no.
I heard. Yeah.
No, stop it.
It's like a Muppet baby.
Oh.
He's
riffing.
Baby Binks.
I love it. Let's bring up the band. Everybody loves the Kill Tony band. We're one of the only shows in the belly room that have a live band that plays with it. this week's fun because we're missing a limb with Jeremiah Watkins in Kansas. So, ladies and gentlemen, I give to you tonight's Kill Tony band. It's Pat Reagan and Joel Jimenez, everybody. Oh.
Yeah, Red Band.
Oh.
Well job, Brian.
I think I know what's happening. Wow.
Hey, well done.
An amazing George Michael tribute. From the band. Yeah. I always love the fact that there's, like, you guys have, like, very limited props always, you know? Like, you can't invest a lot of money into it or anything like that. But what's funny to me is, like, the wigs that you guys rewear for different characters. Like, your George Michael wig is just your Hillary Clinton wig backwards.
There are only two wigs.
I know backwards. From working with you so often.
Backwards.
But it's just a backwards Hillary.
Yeah. Only have two wigs.
Were you were you guys big? You're the musicians of the group here. Were you guys big George Michael fans?
No, I don't get it. I don't get all the outpouring of love.
What?
You're young.
And I'm just saying that I never really connected with his music. So I was just surprised that everyone came out and was like, "Oh, I've loved George Michael so much." To me, R.I.P.
How old are you?
I'm 39.
39.
Yeah. You don't years young.
Oh, okay.
Right. Yeah.
It surprised me.
Yeah.
You're old enough to know how great he was.
Yeah, I have gray pubic hairs. All right.
It was my second record.
Do you?
It was my second record. I remember just fucking...
You loved him, right?
Oh, yeah. Playing that over and over and over.
Were you upset he died?
Of course I was.
Me too.
Yeah. That was this whole year sucks so bad. I'm just waiting for two more before this week.
You and I grew up the same generation. Like, everybody that you and I had posters of, like, if I was like Cyndi Lauper or like Boy George, I would go in hiding for the next 6 days.
Anyway, our friend Jeremiah Watkins, who's not with us tonight, plays Careless Whisper regularly on the show.
I think we got somebody on the phone.
Really?
What?
What?
Is that true?
If it's George Michael, I'm out.
Hello? Is somebody there?
Hello, this is Jeremiah Watkins.
Wow, look at
Jeremiah.
That. Live from Kansas City, Kansas.
Hey, I have a bone to pick with Pat Reagan. He just said he's not a George Michael fan.
Thank you.
Wow, that's your buddy who defends you all the time.
I sensed it all the way from Kansas, and I am pissed right now.
You just picked that up with your senses? Wow.
Yeah.
Well, there's also... Okay, we're live streaming if you don't want to use your senses. We're at deathsquad.tv, but anyway. Go ahead. Yes, Jeremiah, continue with this thing. Did we lose you?
We could set this bit up longer, but keep talking.
Hold on, wait. Jeremiah.
Can you hear me?
Yes, very, very clearly.
Okay, perfect. Tony... I'm an emotional wreck today.
Go ahead, yes.
The reason why I'm not there tonight, I couldn't make it, is because I'm right now attending George Michael's funeral.
Oh. Wow.
Oh, wow.
Already happened today, huh?
The funeral happened today. Wow, and you're there? I thought you were in Kansas.
I am in Kansas. They flew the cadaver over here.
Cadaver.
They flew the cadaver.
The dead raccoon.
Wow. I can't believe
they skinned him and then threw him on a plane.
Man, I can't believe they could be so careless with George Michael's corpse.
Careless Whisper.
Yeah, that's why I said that, Jason.
Jeremiah, did you call for any other reason?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, thank you.
This is going to be hard for me. I don't have the emotional strength to play my saxophone.
That's all right.
I would like to do an a cappella version of Careless Whisper if the Kill Tony audience would let me.
Yeah, what do you guys think? Kill Tony audience? You want to hear Jeremiah singing?
There was totally a moment where they weren't going to go with it, by the way. Just to let you know, I could feel the room completely. They were going to leave you cold, but Pat hyped them up. Go ahead, Jeremiah. Let's hear it. A cappella version of Careless Whisper. Please fucking do whatever you want to do.
All right, right, here we go. I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet have got no rhythm. It's easy to pretend. I know you're not a fool. I should've known.
Oh God, you got it.
Jeremiah Watkins, everybody.
There you go. What did we learn here tonight? What did we learn? Many things. One is definitely that Tony gives his friends too much creative freedom. I trust them with everything. Most of the time, it works continuously. That was another time, I guess, in the end there. Oh, we hung up on him. There he goes, Jeremiah Watkins. Live from Kansas.
Goodbye, Jeremiah.
That was hilarious. 2 minutes too long, but hilarious.
I feel like the wrong guy died.
Burn.
You know, Tony,
I'm sure
I'd actually
felt
like to sing an a cappella version of Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go.
No. No. Let's just do it. Let's start the show, guys. You guys ready to do this? This is the show hasn't even started. I know. Sounds crazy. Maybe you haven't been here before. This is a show where, believe it or not, a lot of fucking people sign up randomly out on the front patio. A lot of comedians, just crazy people that just want to go on stage and show off a talent for a minute. And then get interviewed afterwards by me and my funny friends. This is Kill Tony. You guys ready to start the show or what?
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to pull a name out of a bucket. Pretty much anybody can come up here if they signed up earlier. And if I call your name, that means you get 60 seconds. You know your 60 seconds is up and you hear the sound of a kitty. That means wrap it up then, or else you're going to bring out the angry West Hollywood bear. Oh, shit. It sounds angry tonight. And yes, we got another call from Jeremiah Watkins.
This can't be bad.
Wrong guy died, Jason Tebow. I sensed that all the way from Kansas. Ah. I got to go.
Oh, you gotta go? Really? Oh, are we keeping you from something?
He called to say he has to go.
Saying your name a bunch of times? Okay. Bye, Jeremiah.
Love you, Jeremiah.
All right, your first comedian tonight. You guys ready for this shit or what? I'm going to the bucket. This is where the show... I love it. So much fun. All right, this looks like a new name. We're going to get to see 60 seconds. We're going to get to meet for the first time someone named Mia Sirace, everybody. Here we go. So I know your name's not Mia Sirace.
It's Mia Sirace. Mia Sirace is an anagram for I Am Caesar.
How many times did you sign up tonight?
Just once.
Okay.
As Mia Sirace.
All right, cool. All right.
I am.
There he is. Mia Sirace, everybody.
Guys, I'm really upset about a lot of the hip-hop music that's on the radio these days. I don't know about you guys. It sounds like as if a five-year-old is just writing all of the fucking lyrics for somebody, and they just put it on a really tight beat, and everybody goes crazy, right? Have you guys heard this shit? Like, it's really easy. I'll do a real quick example. It's real easy. Look. I am a nice fella, looking for a Cinderella. Gotta go and get her. Bibbidi bobbidi boo. Bitch, I was looking for you. Here is your shoe. Bitch, I'm looking for you. Here is your shoe. Cinderella, fucking Rella. Cinderella. And it's that easy, right? Watch. I be sending her kisses. I be sending her flowers. I be sending her dick pics. Cindy sent her my tower. Hey, Cinderella. If anybody wants to help me shoot this, I got lyrics and I got the song. Thank you.
Boom.
Mia Sirace.
How's it going, man?
Pretty good. Thank you.
Cool.
Classic closer. If anybody wants to help me shoot this.
Do you mean that? You want some, you, do you, are you looking for someone to help you shoot it?
Yeah, absolutely. I got the script written, and I put it.
You should put that in the act.
No, well, nah.
How long
But I do have the song.
This is
on
gold.
A song. I have a friend who's a dope producer. And I was like, hey, man, let me put my shitty-ass lyrics on your song. And he's like, cool. And we recorded it like 3 weeks ago. So
wow. There you go. Oh, a little bit of organ.
Your friend's
whatever
a dope producer. You mean he makes drugs?
There you go.
And there you have it.
That's
shout out
boy,
to Brian
Patty
Poehler.
Reagan. That's fun. What do you do for work?
I'm a bartender.
Where at?
One of the places I was at just got shut down. It was Loteria on the Promenade, RIP.
Why?
I also work at the Arsenal on Pico.
Why did it get shut down?
Bad management, shitty ownership.
It's not like you got to see.
Cockroaches. Cucarachas.
Yeah.
That was the Santa Monica Promenade?
Yeah.
That was fun. Anything crazy ever happened there? You bartend for a long time?
Just a couple of years.
There?
Like a year there, yeah. They told us on Saturday that they were closing on Sunday, and that was like 3 weeks ago. So.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Now I only have two jobs, or now I only have one job.
That's what happens when you get a C. It's like, we're closing tomorrow.
So, Mia Sarace.
It is an anagram for I am Caesar. I thought about this like for 5 minutes.
That's cool.
Sorry.
Oh, wow.
So... All right. Well, what else in life? How long have you been doing stand-up?
2 years in October.
What do you do for fun?
I don't know. I like to turn up. I have a girlfriend. I spend a lot of time with her.
I like
we go to
turn
the movies
up. I have
shit.
A girlfriend.
I don't know. I beatbox. That's the, I fucking,
that's
I don't
the
know.
Phrase of the night right there. I like to turn up. I have a girlfriend.
I have to turn up yeah. with my girlfriend. How should know?
How long have you two been together?
About a year. Actually, I met her at Loteria, and then after a month,
wait, that was
we
the name of the that was the name of the bar you bartended at? Yeah, it sounds
lottery.
Like it would be shut down yeah. the next day.
Cockroaches.
Yeah.
Yeah. Didn't work out in their odds.
I met her at La Cucaracha, and then
so you met
closed.
Her, and what ethnicity are you?
I'm Dominican.
And what ethnicity is she?
She's from Montana.
Wow. Holy shit. So you guys have been together a year?
Yeah.
You met her parents yet?
Through like FaceTime.
Whoa.
Yeah,
but is there a filter that you put on to look whiter on the FaceTime? Have they made that yet? Have they made the black boyfriend
yeah.
FaceTime filter?
There's gotta be.
That's a fucking good idea,
good
by
app.
The way.
That is a good
Can
app.
You talk to some tech people tomorrow and we'll like split it or
yeah.
something?
Turn up the contrast.
Let's fucking sell that shit. Black boyfriend FaceTime. So I want you to meet Tyrone.
Damn.
Well, he looks good to me, sweetheart. Just gonna go back to my Montana business now.
Are you checking your fantasy scores right now?
No, bro.
Hey, no questions for the
you
guests.
Had a good set. You had a good set, bro.
Thank you.
I'm almost losing.
All right, so... Fuck yeah. Anything else? Any other fun... You have any special skills or talents? You skydive or anything like that?
No, I beatbox.
Do you?
Yeah, I don't know.
How often do you get to do that?
You know,
why
like...
Why do you... And more importantly, why do you have... Okay, forget it.
What?
He was going to play the organ. I'm like, he just pulled out his organ for a second when he said beatbox.
I could beatbox
Brian, like,
with
the organ.
Brian
pretended like he had something great. And I'm like, an organ? What,
if you
what
play
are you
the
about
organ,
to do?
I could beatbox on it.
I played an organ at my grandma's funeral.
According to Brian, nothing goes better with beatboxing than a good old... Oh, wow. Okay. This is one of the worst
corrected.
Episodes of this show of all time. I'm just going to come
I
out and
corrected.
Say it. I've been sitting on it for about 15 minutes just to let you guys know. If you're like, well, this is sort of weird and sucks, it's because it does. Trying to dial it back in by calling it out, and it's actually working. There you go. Thank you. Fuck yeah. All right. Well, Mia Sarace, it was nice to see you again. We'll see you again soon. There he goes. Mia Sarace. Flying through it, baby. On to the next one. On to the next one. By the way, I don't think I ever really should have ever have to say this, and it is the first time I'm saying it in 189 episodes, but comedians or brand new entertainers, if you ever notice that there's a buzz in the room, yeah. audibly, when you're listening, which you should be, like, and performing... then it's you. It's you, and it's the way that you hold the microphone.
Check your mic.
And move your hand or do something, because it's not our microphones. Because we're professionals. So it wouldn't, even if it was, even if our microphone buzzed, we would do a shake and move our hand to make it not buzz. So if you guys hear it, it's you. Make an adjustment.
Just do a little shake. Do a little shake of the microphone.
It's happened enough times to where I'm like,
because
okay,
the buzz
I
you hear
I...
is not industry talking about you.
It was terrible, but great at the same time. All right. This looks like another new name. Put your hands together for John Joriff.
Start. All right. So it's I just made it to Hollywood for the first time, and like many new people, you know, I asked one of the locals, got any suggestions? You got any recommendations? You know what he told me? He said, "Well, there's drugs." Well, there's drugs. He said that shit like he was telling me a landmark or something. Like I can just imagine how bad he is at giving directions. Where are you trying to go? All right. You're going to start off on weed, right? Then you're going to make a right on shrooms. Now, it's going to seem like you're on shrooms for quite some time. But just power through it, you're going to be fine. All right? Now, you're going to run into pills. You're going to run into coke. But if you run into heroin, turn around. You have gone too far. Oh. How much more time is that?
Four more seconds. You got it, man. Right. That's John Joriff. Cool as fuck.
That was great.
I like everything about you, John. Nice to meet you. You seem like a badass motherfucker. Where are you from?
Detroit.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's
Detroit.
One of those things. That's awesome. How long you been visiting?
I've been in.
You live here?
Yeah, been in Cali for just a year now.
Oh yeah. I could feel like, I could still feel you have, some spirit to you. So I knew it wasn't. I knew you were either visiting or you haven't been there that long, or somehow you're just able to maintain that. Do you meditate?
You have hope.
Yeah, actually I do.
Yeah. I can tell. That's how cool I am. I can tell when people meditate. Keeps your freshness.
What kind of meditation? Do you have an app or do you?
Whatever's on YouTube, man. You know.
That's it.
I'm a YouTube meditator.
Yeah. YouTube's a useful resource.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I use it for various things.
I meditate on YouTube, too. I really don't. Actually, I meditate on WorldStar. That's what I like to do.
When you meditate on YouPorn, you've been in L.A. too long.
It's levels.
That's awesome. You have a really cool look. You live in over in the east side? Or
San Diego right now.
San Diego.
Oh, shit. You look like your dad's named Cornelius.
Glasses real?
Yes.
All right.
I picture that Cornelius thing, too. Cornelius, a professor. You know what I mean? Is he a professor?
No.
Teacher?
No. Engineer.
Engineer.
Really?
Yeah.
What does your mother do?
She's a retired Coast Guard. Yeah.
Co-star.
Co-star.
Coast Guard.
Oh, I thought for sure you said co-star. I'm like.
So reverse military, like your mom beat your dad in arm wrestling.
There you go.
Yeah. Like Coast Guard and like nerd. Like, oh, lady, you got me again.
How about you, John? What do you do for work?
I'm in retail. I'm shift lead at Walgreens.
There you go.
How
old are you, sir?
I'm 34.
Okay. How long have you been doing comedy?
You outlived Jesus.
6 years.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah.
What'd
you
say?
Jesus only lived to be 33 before they chopped his head off and filmed it and put it on the internet. Did you hear about this?
Yeah, I heard about that.
Wait a second. That would really change some written history. The
I
old beheading of Jesus.
I believe you're right. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
Wow. The shift. Did you say shift manager?
Shift. Yeah.
What does that entail? What's the worst part of your day job? What's the worst thing you have to do as a comic going to do this shit job where you walk in and you go like, fuck, now I got to tell Dave he's a fucking it up.
Yeah, what is it that you hate about Walgreens the most? Like, I used to work at Starbucks like a long time ago, and I could tell you they made me wear a baseball cap and a green apron, and I didn't like it one bit. It ate up my fucking soul every second.
Blue brings out my eyes more.
All right, that impression has never worked on this show.
6 years, man.
So what is it about Walgreens?
Yeah, yeah. Worst part.
This is pretty laid back, actually, man. It's they tell people it's nothing funny about it. I don't know.
No, I'm saying the worst part about your job. Like, what do you hate to have to do?
I hate my coworkers. They suck.
Why do you hate them?
You have to make their schedules too, because you're the shift leader.
Not. You would think that by the title.
Oh.
But it's very misleading.
You don't really. You're not much of a leader.
I'm like the front man for the people that should get the blame.
Oh yeah, you're sick of telling Mexicans what to do. We understand what you're saying here.
Wow. Which what's the city location of your Walgreens?
San Diego.
Oh, San Diego Walgreens.
You guys
fancy.
Don't have the long receipts like CVS, do you?
Oh yeah.
Why does CVS and you guys both have the long receipts? Like, why only pharmacies have to do that?
You're right. You really do get the blame for everything in your position. Question for you, John. What's up with your receipts that you're making us all carry around?
No other stores do this.
I'm going to have to talk to my manager, and I'll get back to you.
Is it for Band-Aid reasons? Like, it's more times that they can cut their fingers or something like
oh
that?
Oh, my God. You're out of control.
Band-Aid business.
All right. Back to the soundboard for you.
Does Walgreens have a soul?
That's deep, man. I don't know about
they quit.
That,
they quit selling cigarettes, correct?
CVS.
That's CVS. Yes. Walgreens. That's CVS.
Walgreens still sells cigarettes?
Money.
Do they ever?
Represent American spirit.
I always thought that was weird that pharmacies also sold alcohol and cigarettes. And that was like their one of their biggest money.
That's medicine, bruh. That's medicine, bruh.
That's funny, medicine, bruh. So, John, what else is cool about you? I mean, you do anything else in San Diego for fun? What made you go
take your glasses off when you eat pussy?
Ooh, that's good. That's good.
I do.
No pink eye for that guy.
All right. More pink eye.
More.
Wow.
More pink eye for that guy. That's a t-shirt.
So if you're making out, do you take your glasses off?
Oh, no, no, no.
No.
Just not making out, just eating pussy. He takes his glasses off. Shit's getting real.
What kind of ladies
do you
like?
The whole time.
Are you attracted to a certain type of lady?
My wife, right?
Good answer.
Well said, well said, well said.
Good answer.
Is she here tonight?
No, she's not.
Okay, then what kind of girl do you really like?
Where's she from?
She's from San Diego.
Okay.
San Diego thing's starting to make sense.
Is she in the military?
Yeah. Nope.
Good.
Well, that's fun. How often do you get to make it up to L.A.?
This is actually my third time up here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, how often do you do stand-up in San Diego? A lot? You do a lot of spots?
As often as I can.
That's cool. Yeah. Well, fun times, John. I mean, what can I say? Anything else you want to say?
No, thanks for the stage time, guys.
What if when you threw to him, anything else you want to say?
Yeah.
I don't have anything right now. But
right.
What if he said something
I know.
Just out of the blue?
I know. Totally. And it's one of those things to where every once in a while I ask it. After I ask it, every single time, and it always ends up okay. But for a second, I'm always like, why am I even fucking
But what if it was like some even weirder? Tony, what if he was just like, yeah, actually, I do. Don't trust Puerto Rican women.
Amen.
And we're like,
yeah.
What?
Exactly.
All right, have a good night, everyone.
Can you imagine if Woody Allen's next movie was called Don't Trust Puerto Rican Women?
All right.
Would that surprise anyone, though? I mean,
John Joriff, ladies and gentlemen. There he goes.
Happy New Year, bro.
He's on Twitter at J_got_jokes. J got jokes. J-A-Y, by the way. That's a bad Twitter handle, man. If you're going by John Joriff.
Never have an underscore either. You can do
anything. Yeah.
Underscores are bad. You have another guy's name in your Twitter handle named Jay. J-A-Y.
Yeah.
John, why is your Twitter handle J-A-Y? Yell it as loud as you can. Oh, J-A-Y? Your nickname's not just the letter J? They spell it out with extra letters?
Like a J-bird.
If J was my nickname, I'd be like J, but no A-Y. That'd be a thing.
You got to fix that Twitter, dude.
Yeah, you got to just go with an all-new Twitter. How many followers you got?
Not enough to...
You know how many followers you have. What's the number?
I got to say,
What's the exact number? I know that you know the fucking number.
Rhymes with 60.
Five, maybe 500.
Jorf juice.
We'll follow him.
I'd start from scratch. All right, I pulled another name out of the bucket. We know this guy. I'm pretty sure he like started on this show. Put your hands together for Taylor Rizzo.
All right.
All right. I feel like my beard is kind of confusing because people will just come up to me and just guess my ethnicity. And like, nobody ever gets it right, but they always want to know, you know? And like, to be honest, the truth is that I'm just a quarter, whatever I want to tell you. You know, you'll probably believe me. But like, sometimes a black person will think that I'm part black. And like, that always feels cooler for some reason. I was talking to this girl the other day, and she's half black. And she asked if I had any black in me, and I played it off cool. I was like, hell yeah. I'm a quarter black. And she believed me, and it felt cool that a half black girl accepted me as a quarter black, you know? And then I noticed that her friend was standing right there listening, and he was a full black, and giving me a real skeptical look, you know? And I thought that I'd been found out, but just then, he steps forward, and he fist bumps me. He says, yeah. I know a nigga beard when I see one. I was like, apparently you don't. All right, thanks, guys.
Wow, Taylor Rizzo. There you go.
That was great.
Yeah, very fun. It's a good set.
Yeah, thanks.
Good little bit you got there.
I was nervous. Could you tell?
No.
No?
No, not that clearly. I didn't think...
No, yeah. I think
everyone's nervous.
I think the quarter black that you have in you helps your confidence and swagger on stage.
A little but bit. Everyone's nervous all the time, at least for my in my head.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. Is that what goes on underneath that backwards Hillary wig?
Yeah.
So Taylor,
what's up?
That's fucking fun.
Yeah, did it go okay?
Yeah. How long have you had that beard for?
Shit.
Wait, what?
How long have you had that beard for?
A long time. I haven't shaved for like 4 years.
What's the reason for it?
I don't have a chin.
Yeah, you have a weak chin.
Yeah, I have a small no chin.
Wow.
Have you ever thought of just to cut it down, though, to make it look less, you know, terrorist-y?
No, I have bits about it. It's important to my act.
Do you have a girlfriend?
Yeah, I'm kind of dating somebody long distance right now.
Oh, drop the bits, man.
Yeah.
Long distance.
Maybe.
How long distance?
She lives in Denver.
Denver.
Mm-hmm.
How long have you been dating her?
A long time. We were dating before I moved, and then we just kind of never stopped.
Did you live in Denver before this?
No, we both lived in South Carolina, and then I moved here, and she moved to Denver for separate reasons. Super interesting.
Have you been away from her?
Like a year since I moved here.
How often do you get to see her?
She comes to town every couple months. It's only like $80.
Once every, like, half shave.
Yeah.
Half shave.
I don't know.
Did you say it's only $80?
Yeah, flew here was $80, yeah.
Wow.
Super cheap.
Spirit.
Yeah, Spirit.
Jesus.
Don't ever fly Spirit.
An $80 flight.
Yeah,
my God.
Cheap.
Fuck Spirit.
Get in. We'll let anybody in.
I have a question. How much?
Yeah.
even people with beards like your boyfriend. Get on the flight. It's just a whole flight of
how
people
long
that
have
you look
been
like
doing
you.
Stand-up?
A little over 4 years.
How much time can you do? Like you would feel comfortable doing this long of a set?
I mean, I could do 15 easy, but so I could do a feature set.
No, but in 15 minutes, how much of that is about your beard?
Oh,
or your look.
Yeah. Just like two jokes. There's like a joke that
what's
is,
the length
is about
of time,
it.
Though? What's like, because you just did 1 minute pretty much on.
So
a
I have
beard, sort
another
of.
1 minute joke that is referencing my beard and my look. And then there's like one other joke where it's just a reference to it, but that's about it.
You could always say, okay. I had a beard like this.
Right.
You know, yeah. I mean,
I like the beard. I don't want you to think.
If you would have just said to me 8 minutes, I would have said, cut your goddamn beard off.
That's the worst advice
you know
I've ever heard you give, by the way.
You know, if you were to said half of 15 minutes, is about my look or my
beard.
No,
it's not a lot.
Shave the beard, but
the beard is here more so for the lack of chin than anything
else. Yeah, but you could shave it down a little instead of having, you know.
Like, do you really not like it?
No. I don't mind it.
I don't mind it personally, but Brian, it's, you seem to hate it a lot.
You have a good face, and it's like, oh, it's a nice face. Oh, gay. Like, it just gets.
Yeah. Follow-up question.
It does seem like you seem like you'd be a clean cut, like a young CEO from the nose up.
Really?
And then everything underneath is just like,
if you would shave your beard, you would look like Zach Braff had AIDS. I'm into that.
I'll take that.
Follow-up question. Under your sweatshirt, is there dynamite connected to a cell phone?
No. I get a lot of that terrorist shit, though.
So you've been in L.A. a year. I'm pretty sure we met you right when you got here, right?
Yep.
You talked me into
the right decision on moving out here. You guys were a big part of that. You and Brian.
That's on you, Tony.
Is that what happened?
It's when we went to Florida, right?
Yeah, well, I met you in Florida, and then you told me to take a chance, just check it out first, and that's when I met Tony. And
save money, don't move right.
Yeah, yeah.
Right, well, that's cool.
Yeah, it's awesome.
What if you didn't shave 4 years ago because of wanting to look more ethnically ambiguous in Obama's America?
Oh, I just knew it was going to be terrible from the second you started talking. I mean, like, I just very rarely do I start shaking my head immediately, but
Tony,
you had already misjudged, like, the moment itself, the part where you shouldn't even start.
Yeah. I'm pretty positive I can quote Red Band's advice in Florida a few years back.
You should totally move to Blurbank.
Oh, there you go.
That was sort of it. Yeah.
Another one. another one.
Wow. And live.
Oh, man. Wonderful.
Jesus. So, Taylor, you've been here a year. How's life changed in the year in L.A.? I mean, let's talk real talk. Yes. Where are you living? What's your work situation?
I mean, I have a great job. I've gotten a promotion since I've been here, so I'm making more money.
What do you do?
I work for Urban Outfitters. I build all the interior.
Big promotion. He went from a folder to the register.
No, he definitely doesn't work at Dollar Shave Club.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh,
there you go.
There you go.
But I
so
now we've gone backwards.
Silly. No, but I build all the stuff that they have inside the store, so it's like a creative job that I don't have to.
You don't have to deal with customers.
Yeah, I don't have to deal with customers or register any of that stuff, so it's nice. And I still have the nights to go out and do shows and everything. And
nice.
It's been a crazy year, man. Doug Benson put me on both of his podcasts a few times.
That's nice, dude.
Based on the beard alone.
Yeah, the beard, not my weed smoking abilities.
Well, that's fun.
But yeah, it's been...
You smoke a lot of weed?
I do, yeah.
He dabs all days.
I sure do. I have a Periscope show that I smoke on every day. Mediocre smoker. Check it out.
Steve, you're a nice guy.
Yep.
How's life?
How long have you been here?
Yeah, I know.
Good to see you. I didn't know you were here.
Yeah. I was just going to say, like, just from a comedy perspective, I think it's good. Like, I don't even know if you realize what you're doing, and I know there's a lot of comics here, but when you acknowledge your appearance as, like, an opening joke, it's a great way to connect with an audience, because on a deeper level, what you're doing is you're sitting yourself in the audience, meaning what are they thinking about me right now?
Right.
So once you can establish that connection, then you could take the audience wherever you go.
Yeah,
because
they're all thinking, like, what the fuck's on his face?
Right.
What? Right, but it's a good move. Like
that can't be what everyone was thinking, right?
Right? 70s Bush.
It does look like a 70s Bush. Right. Like, it's not like a long, you know, like long hairs. It's like a little pubic.
It's pretty weird.
All right, Brian. You're talking way too much tonight, Brian.
Yeah, he doesn't like it at all.
Yeah.
Real talk, I mean... Yeah. Never mind.
Yeah. Taylor Rizzo, everybody. There he goes.
Good job, brother.
He's on Twitter at Taylor Rizzo. Jesus. You guys having fun, live audience? How are you?
Yeah.
All right. I pulled another name out of the bucket. Put your hands together for Luke Allen. All right, no Luke Allen. You know what that means. You know what happens when someone doesn't show up. That means you get to see the stylings of the Verzi Triplets, ladies and gentlemen. The special wild card spot.
Hey.
Very wild, yeah, I didn't even know. You know, we've been thinking about if we were ever going to run Train on a Bitch, you know? Yeah. I know we look like we only do missionary, but, you know, it'd be less of a train, more of a Congo line.
Yeah.
Kind of a fun vibe with us, you know?
We would be very polite gangbangers, though. We'd
very
be
polite.
So hospitable. Like, can we take your coat?
Can I get you something to drink?
May I double stuff your cunt?
You know, like that. Just very... very nice. Very
real sweethearts.
Very nice.
That's what we do.
It's just how it'd be.
We had to all get on the same page, you know. We talk beforehand.
Huddle up. All right.
All right.
Alex, you're taking the mouth.
Got it.
Sean, we need the lube and towels. Go get it. I'm going up the gut. Ready? Break.
All right.
Here we go.
Oh, okay.
And then we would just compliment her. It'd be like fucking a mirror, pretty much.
Yeah, kind of a little bit, you know?
Dude, you've been working on your abs?
You know, I've been doing this, like, new workout. A lot of crunches every morning. You know, it's working pretty well. Oh,
dude,
easy.
I'm going to come right now.
Yeah, no, I mean...
I've got orange slices!
Hey, okay. Thank you, guys.
Wow, the Versi triplets on the fly.
Great job, guys.
I caught a glance at one of you guys up there in the shadows, and when nobody came up, I saw you guys, so I spontaneously decided to bring you up, because you're one of my favorite things in all of comedy right now.
Thank you.
You guys are totally somewhat god-awful.
That's what we've heard.
But there are glimpses of things, and I'm going to tell you guys this. First of all, I know a lot of you live audience may not have... heard or been part of last week's episode, but you guys directly answered a note that we gave of talking about, you know, darker subject material, and it's sort of a misdirect because you guys are so goofy and jolly that finally, like, hearing the third one say, you know, double stuff a cunt.
Love that line.
It seems like you guys are like 12-year-olds just getting away with murder. Like, your parents don't know you left the house.
Yep.
And you're like, let's all go talk about gangbanging a chick on a show.
We actually debated on the... they wanted me to only say pussy, and I'm like, no, it'll be funnier if I say cunt.
Clam, twat, anything other than... everyone hears pussy.
It was a 20-minute argument.
What's another thing that makes people go, that joke is funny, and then he used this other word. Everyone hears pussy. It's almost invisible. Yeah. You say cunt, clam, twat, hamburger, whatever. Anybody, you hear it. Joey Diaz is great at that. You listen to the way they use different... use your own vernacular... to say things people understand.
And it's all different. To you. And it never changes, but it's fun because you guys were talking about, you know, happy-go-lucky stuff, and it's a fun exercise, and that works for some people. But it was sort of like, and you guys were feeling it, right? It felt like stale, and it felt like your responses were stale, but all of a sudden you're getting these new pops because you're using your look to your advantage both by talking about it and setting up a misdirect. Just like, you know, if somebody thinks someone's going to be tough or whatever, and instead they're not or anything like that. Yeah. You're setting it up because they think you're a bunch of jolly kids, and all of a sudden you're getting away with murder up there. Yeah. So, wow. I would try to tap into more, you know, fun stuff and experiment with stuff like that.
Agree.
Steve Simone is your guys' older brother.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Originally, Steve Verzi changed it to Simone for the
stage.
He said
he used to fart on you, so.
When we heard that Steve was a guest, we're like, oh, this is the one time we're going to do dirty stuff, and he's going to see it.
It is sort of really funny, and it just hit me when I was talking about how you guys should keep adventuring in the edgy space, because you really don't do that. You are the ultimate storytelling, energized, goofy, fun-loving.
But it used to be really dark. It's
like, was?
Yeah.
I guess back in the day, I do
my head off.
I do remember the very first time I was ever here and I performed, I remember thinking like, wow, that guy seems like a real dick. And I couldn't have been more wrong. Like, it's so funny. Like, cut to me seeing him for the first time tonight. I'm like, hey, Steve. And he's down the stairway here and I'm at the top of this belly room stairway. And he just goes, I got, what was it? I got ice cream and treats for everybody.
They're downstairs if you guys want.
It's like, and that's just him.
That's 100% true.
And you're 100% clean. Family-friendly comedy, which here at the Comedy Store, to be on that level is almost unheard of.
Yeah.
And what it says is that you're smart as fuck and super talented because you're taking no shortcuts. You're just, it's who you are and you did it your way. And it's one of the coolest things.
Yeah, and that's why I think your advice is great for these guys, because you have to experiment. You have to figure out where the boundaries are, what you want to do, how you want to present it. and it's what you have is so unique already, and it's so retro and old school. And no matter what, since you're family, the vibe I get, it always feels like you're performing for your aunts, uncles, and grandparents. So you're going to have that warmth. So when you play around with the juxtaposing that with dart or whatever you want to do, you're it's money in the bank. You're fine.
I have a question that I'm really excited to ask. One of the three of you has a Band-Aid on your bottom
lip. That's my note. My only note.
You wrote that? You got that? Oh, you
my
do
note
have a
is
pen and
three
paper.
Band-Aids or no Band-Aids when you come out as triplets. Because I'll tell you why, and you know, everyone laughs, but I'll tell you why. When you come out, immediately everyone goes, they're triplets, one Band-Aid, why? And they are not paying attention while you're doing your shit.
Yeah.
And you're setting something up, and you're doing something that's distracting when it comes out.
It wasn't it's herpes like a, on birth.
If a 450-pound person comes out and starts talking about their dating life, the audience immediately subconsciously goes, why aren't they talking about being 450 pounds right out the gate?
Yeah.
So we can agree that we agree on what's up. And you guys all came right. out, we're Tony, triplets, Tony. And we're exactly the same, and then we think it's a gag.
Jason, you're letting these guys off the hook. Tony. What the fuck's under the Band-Aid, dude?
I ate an elbow playing basketball, and it's just fucking
You ate an elbow?
I was hoping
Take the Band-Aid off. I want to see it.
I was hoping it was going to be a fourth.
I don't want to rip it. I don't want to rip the skin.
You know it's a cold sore. Tony. Because it's... Hold on, wait a second. Stop for a second. Then we're going to get right back to the take it off chant. You know that it's a cold sore because his two brothers were the ones that started the chant.
Yeah. Tony.
The only two guys in the room that know that it's a cold sore started a take it off chant while
I am
laughing.
Willing to take bets that it is a fourth thing that looks like them. Go ahead.
And it's
it was a cold sore. It was a cold sore, and I put so much makeup on.
Wait a second.
What?
You lied about the basketball thing?
Yeah, of course I did.
Oh my God.
Of course I did.
There's not a cold sore.
First, it's called two. Herpes. How could you?
Holy
It's a Netflix
shit.
Injury.
There was a reason why. Because I didn't want to have this fucking
By the way,
but you
I
don't
knew
lie
it.
About a cold sore.
No, you don't
lie about herpes.
Here's what you don't do. You don't lie about it and then confess on the same show a minute and a half later that you lied. Literally 90 seconds goes by. That's going to be a fucking gif, by the way.
Oh, my God.
Congratulations. Wow. You two must just be eating that up as triplets. Yeah. Just like, oh, well, look which one of the DNA fucked up. Man.
Hey, I have a question. Have any of you conspired to be like, we have a much better twins act if we kill old fuckface?
me and herpes here both.
Of course.
Let me.
I think old fucking Band-Aid on the fucking face. I think old Band-Aid beard better fucking sleep with his eyes open.
Let me ask you a question, Verzi number two. Do you remember? Do you know who it was?
I don't know.
Really?
No.
Wow, you guys are banging that many triplets.
Oh, that gangbang, that's a snippet of our real life, that gangbang.
Did you just notice that they clapped at the same time like a football team? Like they just broke a huddle or something like that? And break.
And
that was impressive. You guys really are fucking triplets. How old are you?
24.
Tony,
24.
You know what I love about them? You know what I love about you guys? Seriously. And is that you guys are earnest, despite your cheesiness, your inherent
You guys
cheesiness.
Are earnest. You're earnest, goes to jail, in fact, because you're not funny at all.
But you're hard... But,
Nothing
but,
on that? Like, you guys are assholes. This is an asshole audience.
This is actually...
Earnest goes to jail?
This is a...
Shut up.
Something
fuck
you. Can take from... Is that your hard work?
Read the people on Twitter all day going to be like, that dumb audience didn't laugh at Earnest goes to jail. I refuse to let this die.
You're earnest, you're hardworking, and there's three of you. So you've got that. Okay, but that wasn't my joke, Tony. That was a serious joke.
That wasn't a joke, so it couldn't have been your joke.
I have a joke for you guys. If you guys are like, well, there's one thing we all like, and you go and you and two of you say sports, and one of you says anal.
And then
you can call it back later and be like our favorite sport is and then two of you say basketball and one of you says anal again.
Okay. And by the way, you guys also have to start opening your brain and taking chances to the point but to where the thing that you guys and you did great, by the way, and I'm telling you, in 1 week you took a fucking note and people don't do this. But you guys took a note and you really answered the note. You took it head on. You wrote a bit that's completely outside of your realm. But on time. It just goes to show that the fucking, you know, the training never ends, because what you really I'm pitching here is that what you guys should have talked about is the thing that we were sort of, at least I was wondering, which is, why does the one have a Band-Aid on his lip? Like, when you guys are writing the day of and taking chances,
I might have a
and talking about talking about the elephant in the room, and by that I'm talking about whatever's underneath that Band-Aid, then, I mean, you're going, like, next level. And I'm not saying you shouldn't have done what you did, but I'm saying, like, you know, you guys have to start going, like, we can make fun of anything, and you can riff and...
We were trying
chances.
To be nice. He didn't want us to talk about it, so we were trying to be nice and not talk to it.
But that's here's another next level lesson is like
two versus
you gotta
one.
Open up. Right. You know what I mean? It's part of what you got yourself into is that if you don't have the, you know, the makeup or the know how to cover up something like that or the medicine or whatever it is.
He went out and bought like a huge thing of cover up and it still didn't work.
Look how upset he is. This is beautiful.
And that's my follow up question, Tony. If all three of you get a vote for the other guy in 5 years, let me hear your vote.
Wait, listen
Which
to all
one
the ladies about
gay.
Listen to all the ladies that have cold sores yelling at each other in the background.
It's not just that. It could be a whole plestitude of things.
I sort of feel fucking bad for him. Pop.
If all three of you get a vote in 5 years, which one of you is gay?
Whoa!
You see how fast that was? That was fast.
That was great,
dude. They said that like they you might have something to announce right now.
It's just because it's because I shaved my chest. That's why they think.
Oh, is it, bro? Is that it?
Is that the only reason?
Let's ask them why they said that
come on,
so fast.
Come on, Cold Sore, get your fucking revenge. This guy started chanting.
He's very into himself. He's kind of like Patrick Bateman is. He's really into his body and obviously.
He snores with cocks in his mouth.
Verzi number three. What's the gayest thing you've ever had in your butt? No, that's Verzi number one.
It's a strong question.
You, Tony.
Oh, you son of a bitch. Hallelujah. It's raining, man. All right, there they go, the Verzi triplets, ladies.
Thank you, guys.
Gentlemen.
Good job, guys. Happy
Great
New Year,
stuff.
Man. Great job, guys.
Yeah, man. You can't hate on people that take the notes. That's fucking incredible.
Hard work. Hard work will get you further than anything else.
And that's coming from a guy who, admittedly, you lashed out on them harder than I've ever seen you lash out on anybody ever. You hated them when you first saw them, and... That's what you just said. That's what I'm saying. The growth of that little storyline of the Verzi triplets is pretty awesome.
Respect.
One more time for the Verzi triplets, everybody. Come on. There's three of them. They should at least get double the applause. I pulled another name out of the bucket. put your hands together for Tom Whalen.
What did I say, Tom?
What's up, everybody? Shit. I've had a tough day. Got my lighter stolen. Sorry, I'm not trying to play the victim. That was an awful joke. I wrote that 10 seconds ago. I live a kind of minimalistic life. I have a
table and a chair. But if you ask drunk me, I have two tables. I watch a lot of porn. I don't think I'm a bad guy for watching porn. I just regret it when I do my morning ritual. I come
podcast
up,
listeners can't hear off. His set.
Tap one off.
You come in on tap one.
Come in on tap one off. Listen, if I'm going to come in, I'm coming in on tap one off. I tap one off, and then I got to go eat breakfast with my roommates who are little Asian girls. And what kind of porn do I watch? Little Asian girls. And they got cream of wheat. They're eating the sloppiest breakfast possible.
Fuck yeah. You done? Tom Whalen, everybody.
Thank you.
He is.
Thank you.
Who would have guessed on the episode in which I mentioned that if the wire gets wiggled a little bit, to just touch the wire to make sure that for the podcast that is live, the podcast,
the
live podcast. Hundreds of thousands of listeners that you would touch the wire to knock it back into place.
Tony,
meanwhile, on that episode, on that very same episode,
Billions of listeners.
I feel like that was a chance for me to showcase my projection.
I had a lot more that I was going to say, but I mean, I guess I'm just like Tony. Spitballing here. Like, I guess if I'm mid-sentence, that means just everybody just jump in as hard as you can. Tony, but okay, let's go on with whatever Brian's shoving down our throats right
Tony,
now. Go ahead, Brian.
How long do you think it takes to plug in a microphone? To bend over and
a
grab
few
it?
A few seconds. Yeah, I was two getting seconds, to a whole thing that seconds. Was funnier than that. Yeah. Anyway, Tom.
I'll say this.
I mean, what are we doing here? Tom.
Yes.
What makes you think, what made you roll with that like that?
You know, I don't know.
You didn't think about the podcast thing?
I was all piss and vinegar, honestly. I just felt like...
Ew. Inexperience.
You know what I'm saying? Inexperience.
Yeah. It's all right.
All balls,
I just
no
feel
skill.
Like it. Like as a human being, there's a lot of people in this room.
Stupid.
I know 100,000 people will listen to this, but this room is packed.
Yeah.
And the mic dropped out. You know you have a minute left. And I actually thought you were very professional about that.
Thank you.
You brought your voice up to a theatrical level, and you conveyed your set. You knew you had 40 seconds left, and you're like, I don't want to spend 3 minutes plugging into a mic. Makes us uncomfortable.
It takes you 3 minutes to plug in a mic, Jay.
Three
That's
minutes.
6 minutes later, it's still not plugged in. Yes!
It's going to take you 2 seconds to plug in a mic. You hire your voice while you bend over to pick it up.
You do
but 190 people or whatever, how many people are in
you
this room
do the
feel uncomfortable
190
in that
people
you do the You do the no-look wire grab. Nope. That there's no question about this. You do a no-look wire grab. You pick that shit up and
you do a thank you 1080. You guys are saving the podcast. When I explained what I thought your moment was, it got an applause break, and I feel like everyone in this room, all 75
really
of them,
break. It was
thought
it was
he
like,
played that good.
It was the Hillary voters.
He could have been embarrassed.
Like, it's like five chicks in the room that lightly clapped together.
He could have been embarrassed, and I feel like
ladies.
He played that good.
Nobody with any goddamn passion or that would show up to the actual voting poll booth. Did I say that right? No. Tom, you are the worst undercover cop comedian I've ever seen in my life.
Tony. That all being said,
what do you
look like you're wearing a wire in high school.
Need for Speed 7, funny jokes.
What do you do for work?
I work at a sandwich place right now.
Of course you do.
I used to. Listen, do you understand that people accept my opinion like it's fact? You look at this belly and you're buying a sandwich when I recommend it.
I'm going to interrupt you. I'm going to interrupt you because you know what you said? You said after you told your first joke, you said, I wrote that in 10 seconds. And it goes back to what we were just talking about with the Verzi triplets, which is hard work.
You're right.
So that's all I have to say.
You're right. No, you're absolutely right. He's right.
What sandwich place do you work at?
The Carving Board. I work in the one in West
Oakland. You are our top sandwich consultant.
Oh, absolutely. Yep.
Have you tried the Carving Board?
No.
Allow me to recommend a sandwich.
Are you at the one on Sunset?
No, like I'm at the one in West Hollywood, but I get the discount, so you know what I'm saying, bro? Ladies.
That's like a Subway guy bragging to me like, dude, let's go to any Subway.
And I'm 50%, like,
let's not.
50%.
How about no?
Let's go.
You have what I would term fear confidence. Do you understand what I mean?
Fear confidence.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure.
And when you get uncomfortable, you just sort of turn into like Chris Farley a little bit, right?
Yeah.
Subconscious.
Or unplug your mic on purpose.
You get like real goofy. Yeah, you do that little goofy smirk.
For sure.
Where are you from?
I'm from the Boston area, North Shore, Beverly, Massachusetts.
Yeah, definitely.
What if you got more and more specific?
Western Street, 910.
Centerville.
GPS location, 11 degrees north.
47 degrees south. Yeah, exactly.
That's fun. How long you been in the sandwich business, Tom?
Nah,
sometimes his whole life.
Sometimes I like to switch over to like
I'm
radio
voice.
I'm
suspecting
out of nowhere. Let me ask you another crazy one. Here comes another wackadoodle.
Yeah.
Here's one question for you, Tom.
Sandwich game's been about 3 months, Tony.
Oh, this late.
You've been in a coma for 27 years?
Yeah. No, I worked at the YMCA before that, and before that, I was actually a radio show host.
Why do I feel like you worked at the YMCA at the only sandwich place there? Like, it wasn't actually the YMCA.
All right, I'm gonna do something.
Sure.
All right.
Yes.
Oh, Jesus.
Put your mic in your
mic. Hope this is a song about how Jared owned the YMCA.
Wait, no, seriously.
Pat, any ideas that you have that last longer than 10 seconds?
Put your mic in the mic stand. That's it. Put your mic in the mic stand.
That's a good one.
Stand behind it. Okay? It's a fucking real note. All right.
I love that. A real note.
Stand behind it. Okay? That's it. Chill. Okay. There you go.
How do you feel right now, Tom?
I feel good.
Do you? Why do I feel like even with the mic in the mic stand, he's so accident prone that the mic cord's just going to bloop and just fall right out? How does it even happen?
He's like a Final Destination movie waiting to happen.
And by the way, let it be known, a lot of audience members don't know this. You know, we do this every single night regularly. If you ever happen to see a mic cord fall out of the microphone, that's because somebody handled the mic not as professionally as they should have. There's actually a little eject button right there if you don't know. So if you hit it, then you hit it. But you're not going to see winners ever really hit it.
I'm not a winner, guys.
Really
don't do what I did.
It doesn't
don't
really
do what
happen.
I did. Hey, Tony, has anybody ever told you you look like the elf in the shelf was molested as a child?
Actually, what's funny is that somebody did once tell me that. There's two people that obviously hate me that over-owed that. And I know who they were, too. Fucking, What was his fucking name? Piece of shit. Mia Sirace, I saw you, motherfucker. Yeah, okay. Tom's
right,
your boy.
Behind. You, no, see, when you did that laugh, yeah. See when you did that laugh and you backed away, it was too much, it was false. So just stay.
Pretend your mustache is telling the joke.
Maybe it wasn't false, but I think because you're under the lights, it was slightly false.
I
think it was slightly exaggerated. And
Tom, do you have roommates?
We're animals.
I do have roommates.
How many roommates do you have?
Two roommates right now.
What do they do for work?
I think they're both prostitutes, honestly, but they hide it. One of them says she's a Lyft driver, and she works for, Central Casting, and the other says that she's in the fashion industry.
Have you ever seen the movie Super Troopers?
Yeah. Farva?
Yeah. Good one. There you go. Brian Redman.
Ladies and gentlemen, Brian Reichel.
Anything else for Tom, guys? Steve Simone, what are your thoughts on Tom? I know you
right away. I could.
How long have you been here,
dude? I could tell you love comedy.
I do.
Like I can, and I think you're a little nervous because it means so much to you.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I think that's awesome. And I realize what makes this great. Mm-hmm. So you're giving everybody an opportunity because there's a real crowd with real energy.
Yep.
And it's just fucking great to be here and to be a part of this.
Cause allows you to play.
I felt you come out. And you're like, this is a real set. Don't mess it up. And then when the mic dropped, I was like, oh my God.
Yeah.
It was adorable and cool.
Thank you, man. Appreciate that.
Joel Jimenez said that he looks like he makes a hell of a deep dish pizza.
Jesus, he did. Like, I mean, you're a big goofball, aren't you, Tom?
Beggars in Chicago, they got that dope deep dish.
Are you from Chicago?
No, but I went to college in Chicago.
Where'd you go, Northwestern?
Columbia College.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Man,
it's the only place that would accept
look.
Me.
Yeah.
Wow, you have an interesting look to you, sir. Really interesting.
You look like a child molester that's scared of kids.
Yeah.
I don't understand it, but I like it.
Yeah, thank you.
On the nose. They intimidate me. I want to keep them as far away as possible.
No. Yeah. But you also want to fuck the shit out of them, too.
Well, there he goes. The carving board's greatest comedian, ladies and gentlemen, Tom Whalen. He's on Twitter at Sir Thomas J. Whalen. Sir Thomas J. Whalen. Oh, shit, we're walking people tonight. This is an interesting crowd. I could tell some people really don't want to be here. I don't know what happened. I don't know exactly if some people, like, overbelieved how bad I thought this episode was, but I make that joke a lot.
This is packed, though. It's holiday, people. Happy holidays.
This lady
everybody.
Right here in the front row, I can't take my eyes off her. Yeah. You guys notice this, too? I love this. This lady right here, I can't take my eyes off her, rest of the audience, and I never get this distracted by an audience member, but I can't take my eyes off of her because she refuses to even look up at this show.
Yeah.
She's so mad whoever brought her here to this place for her to enjoy herself. A place built around humans enjoying themselves.
I've only seen
for decades of history of every single night of the year, people enjoying themselves.
I've only seen the top of her head. I thought she was faking an abortion the whole time.
And it's really incredible. I don't know
the
if you're like
loving
physically
Christmas way.
If you're physically allergic to comedy or something like that, I've never really seen it. But what were you saying? You guys are here, like, specifically to hopefully see somebody in particular?
She's casting spells on your bucket,
Tony. Tony.
Yeah.
Tough front row.
Yeah, it's really tough. I mean, you know, if not, it's all going to be okay. Like, I mean, you really took a gamble. There's, like, there's, like,
she's here, casting
check
spells.
This out. And this isn't even all of them. Check this out. Look at that. Look at that stack. Look at all these names.
Let's have them all do
and
one set
like
at once.
Two or three more.
None of them are Brett Morris either.
Yeah.
But I am going back in.
I'm putting my notes. Good joke, Tony.
Put your hands together for Trevor Anderson.
Ooh.
Could be a cousin of some kind of yours. He could be one of your cousins that you've never met before. Trevor Anderson, everybody. Get the fuck out of here. I want Brett Morris up here right now. Just kidding.
Bring the triplets up.
Yeah, double triplets. Trevor Anderson, put your hands together one more time for him. Here he goes.
All right. So a friend of mine was making fun of me for cooking. He thinks it's girly. Hold on. There's more to this joke. I thought I'd prove him wrong, so I took the manliest implement in my kitchen, the cast iron skillet, and I put everything manly in there. Eggs and bacon and hash browns and onions and everything I could think of, and I just put it in the oven, and it came out this just glorious manly pie, and I said, dude, that is manly. He said, dude, that's a quiche. I used to live in Japan. I made a lot of mistakes out there. Like, for example, I didn't know that Asian people do not like to be associated with or confused for other groups of Asian people. So I asked a Japanese friend, are you North or South Korean? Yeah, he lost his shit. He was throwing stuff. He's like, I'll kill you! I'll fucking kill you! So, North Korean, I guess. All right.
Wow! That's another thing that this show's cool for. You get to meet somebody hilarious sometimes. Yeah. That was great, Trevor. Where are you from?
Originally from Rialto, San Bernardino area.
San Bernardino. How long have you been on stand-up?
About 4 years. Kind of gappy, though.
Kind of gappy.
Yeah.
You don't know many Asians, do you?
Yeah, I do.
Tony, was it just me or when you said that Asian joke, I didn't think there was a punchline coming?
It's funny you say that. It's funny you say that because I actually did. And I got to see, and the moment that you laughed as hard as you did, I literally thought to myself, I'm like, that's surprising that Pat didn't see that. So it's funny that you literally asked me that because I had when he did that joke, my main thing was like, wow, Pat didn't see that North Korea thing. Like, I mean, at least I was hoping. That happens sometimes where I'm like, oh my God, this person figure this out. This is going to get two big laughs. There's the one. Here it comes. And he nailed it. Sometimes people don't have that. Sometimes I'm surprised when you're surprised.
Well, sometimes I wasn't even totally in the moment because I thought that he was set up to kill with the energy in the room. He was totally, at more than any comedian of the night, brought up to an energy that was primed to go.
I'd like to take a little bit more credit than that.
Then the mic happened.
Well, I bet you do, but let me ask you this.
Mic fucked him, though.
That voice cracking on Girly was an accident, correct?
Yeah, it was. If I could do that every time.
You're right.
If you could figure out how to do that every time, that's one of the funniest things I've
ever
seen.
You're right.
And immediately I realized, like, I'm like, oh my God, it was just an accident.
Yeah. And that was the best laugh of the night.
And you had a great set. But it never got better than that.
No,
that
true.
Was the
that's
joke
true.
Of the night. I mean, accidentally, and that's comedy for you.
Exactly.
But if you could figure out a way, and even afterwards, I'm like, even if that was on purpose, it is killer. Like, people will all die for that, and it's not that hard to do, I don't think.
No.
Yeah. Somebody said that I was doing something. Like, I don't know. Yeah. Maybe I can't do it. Maybe it is hard.
And to your credit, your set was great.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. That was awesome.
Yeah, great
set. Thank you.
Why do I feel like you're an anomaly? Why do I feel like you haven't had a ton of negative shit to happen in your life to make you as funny as you actually are?
Yeah, that's weird.
Is that true? Your parents are still together?
Still together.
Healthy?
Theater background?
Healthy. Everything's good? You have a savings account?
I have no debt.
You've had a steady career your entire life?
That's right.
College graduate?
No, yeah.
Get out of comedy. Get out of comedy.
I hate everything, though.
All the signs.
How old are you, Trevor?
I'm 33.
Theater background?
Oh, shut up. Jesus.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Straight, honest with me.
Come
look
on,
at me.
Jason. He can make quiche. Of course
I was raised by lesbians.
Background.
I was raised by lesbians. I was gay before anybody in this room that sucks dick or eats pussy ever even thought about it. I was that kid
Christ.
At that party. Gay or straight? Gay or straight?
Did he just bust out of the closet?
What?
Is that
100%
straight?
100% straight.
100%
straight.
Yeah. All right.
Thanks.
I don't know. I have no idea what just happened.
Out of the closet.
Tony, gay vibe, yeah. Nova.
Honestly,
never
no.
Got
it's,
it.
It's almost like a reverse thing where I almost feel like he's King Pussy Slayer for
yeah.
some reason.
Right.
He seems like the kind of
like
guy
an
that,
evil
like,
genius.
Okay,
people,
now
I feel like people from like the South would think that he's gay, but like I don't know. I think living in West Hollywood for the past decade, I feel like I have somewhat of a decent gaydar, and for some reason, I think you get a ton of pussy.
Yeah, now my
Wait,
mom can't watch the show.
You're wearing a Fender T-shirt. Yeah. Do you play?
I'm just a fan.
Just a fan just of Fender
guitars.
You want to stand by your pussy statement, Tony?
A lot of people like bands yeah. and rock just stars. Me, I give the instrument all the credit.
Yeah. Brian, gay or straight? Vibe.
Straight.
Really?
Yeah. You're sitting too close to his dick.
Yeah, that's what it is.
Smells gay as fuck.
You're a straight vibe. What about a molested vibe?
No, nothing. No, that's what I'm saying. I don't
no
think,
molested vibe.
Let me ask
no
you
molested
this.
Vibe.
All right, let me ask you this. Here we go.
Just Joel?
Trevor, yeah. What is the... What would you consider like one of the worst things to ever happen? Do you ever have your like heartbroken or like, I mean like, you know...
Maybe George up, Michael dying or...
Come up with your own.
Yeah, I was married briefly.
You were?
Yeah.
How old were you when you got married?
23.
Wow. How yeah. old was the girl that you married?
47.
Same age. We were the same age.
Same age. 23.
Yeah, yeah, and she cheated on me and then got into fetish porn, so...
Ooh.
Yeah.
Oh.
That was pretty brutal for me.
Wait, were you on the
I
show
I don't know
before?
What no. they're clapping
yeah, Red
for,
Band
exactly.
woke up quick.
What kind of fetish porn was it?
I don't want to... It's like piercings and like they zip tight her pussy lips.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
They really, zip yeah. tight her pussy?
Yeah, it really hurts.
Zip tight
yeah.
her pussy lips?
I don't know. Like, maybe I probably shouldn't have brought that up.
Trevor,
it's kind of private.
Be honest, Trevor. Be
and
honest.
And is that what made you gay?
He's not gay.
I'll let you know when I figure
Ask
it out.
Ask him for a friend.
He's not gay, but after my new level 2 analysis, he might just be, and correct me if I'm wrong, Trevor, would you consider yourself, do you think you're probably a little bit boring in the bedroom?
I don't think so. I have a great time
every
time.
One of you, would you be willing to share like a cool trick or something like that
yeah.
that you do?
A cool trick?
I don't know. Is there something you ever say or do in which you're like, man, that always works for me?
Yeah, no. I'm sorry. I wish I could think of something, but I
don't
have any.
Don't you be
moves.
A fucking pussy. Right
all right,
now,
all right.
Trevor.
I like a good choking. Yeah.
It's not the right sound effect for that, but it's still
yeah,
funny.
It
you yeah. like you,
take off your glasses for a second.
The way that you just
yeah,
said.
Yeah. See, look at that man. That's what he's a normal guy. He fucking slays pussy.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Why do I feel like now that his glasses are off, a Superman cape's about to fly off from the back of him?
He's got fucking blue eyes.
You look like right, a jester Jesus. Snorted Viagra.
Mm-hmm.
That's how I look at you no. right what, now.
What's up with your voice tonight, Jason? You're like... Bah!
It's a I lot. Mean,
that's how it is.
Trevor.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that breakup was tough for you.
Yeah, it was pretty brutal.
How's it been going now, though?
I'm doing a lot better, yeah.
You on dating websites and stuff?
Yeah, I've done some of that.
Last date you went on, when was that?
Just before Christmas.
And all through the house.
Yeah.
Not a creepy story.
That.
That's a zinger, though. You stumbled into one.
How did that go? What'd you guys do?
We went to dinner and then my house.
Applebee's.
And had you hooked up? And
dinner
you just met,
and then my house. So yeah. Where'd you take her to dinner at?
There's a bar with a like a secret pub in the back room that. It's kind of douchey, but yeah.
A bar with a pub in the back.
Yeah, it's like a speakeasy. I mean, it's like a speakeasy.
Give
yeah.
it to the Bill Cosby of fucking restaurateurs over here. Yeah. Hey, man, I'm starving. How about you? Yeah, you ready for this? There's some whiskey and beer. Let's do this shit. You just get right into it, huh?
So,
did it end up working for you?
Yeah, I mean, I'm going to see her again.
You are?
Yeah.
What right. base What base did you get to with her?
Full.
I'm guessing. What's full. Anal?
Oh,
listen. You son
yeah, I
of
think
a
this
bitch.
Guy's a freak.
The king of the misdirect. Anything else for Trevor, guys? Steve?
I just think you made a good point
yeah.
earlier about his voice cracking. Always, always, always right on stage. Like
yeah.
I think your performance has to come alive in the moment.
Yeah.
Right.
But then the secret is making things that were planned appear not to be planned.
And you can also accentuate them, you know
Absolutely.
What I mean? And it can make it look longer. You can just make it longer by just going for it. Again, I mean, it's just unbelievable. I mean, if you try something, it's going to always get a few chuckles from just people that are, like, surprised and stuff.
Tony, I got a question for you.
Yes, go ahead.
How did you find out?
Same thing goes for you, by the way, that I just said about that.
I know. I know. I picked up.
You guys are both. My bookends are out of control.
Always teaching.
How did you find out your wife was doing zip tie fetish porn?
Yeah.
She sent me the link to her FetLife profile.
Wow. One in the link, two in the stink. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about?
Not very subtle. Your wife. No. Ex-wife.
Did you see it coming? No. I mean, like, was it something that's overnight? Like,
No, I was, so we were both in the Navy at the time, and there was deployments, and we got back. And
it's all about semen.
We got to go, believe it or not, Trevor. Go. Get out of here. We have one last comedian.
It's all about semen.
We have one final comedian. This is a really big deal. Ladies and gentlemen, this young lady has been a regular on this show, writing and performing, not out of the bucket. She writes and performs a brand new minute every single week. It's one of the toughest gigs in all of comedy, writing and performing a new minute every week. That's 60 new minutes per year if executed properly. Not easy to do. Has been, you know, obviously mentored by the last 60 guests on the show. Blah, 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 blah. This is a really big deal, though. It's been an awesome pleasure working with her. Put your hands together for the final one-minute set of Vanessa Johnston, everybody. Here you go.
I feel like that this is the technology problem, not me. So I'm an atheist, which sucks because I'm afraid of the dark. But I still go to church because I like the songs. My favorite part is when they talk about the birth of Jesus and then everyone sings Silent Night because it makes absolutely no sense. Dude, like, this bitch is having a baby in a barn full of noisy animals with a virgin-type pussy. That's the least Silent Night ever. It's more like Bloody Night. Everyone's all upset that Jesus got killed. But, like, dude, he got killed when he was 32. Back then, that was, like, so old, you know? People didn't even start taking Jesus seriously until he was, like, 31. They're like, man, this dude might be the son of God. No one's lived past 30.
Bing, bang, boom. Another new minute from Vanessa Johnston. I love it. I feel like you could have gotten right into son of a bitch. What was the first punchline?
I'm an atheist, which sucks. Compared to the dark. Oh, the Silent Night.
Yeah, the Silent Night. You could have just gotten right into, like, mm-hmm. you know, fucking Christmas is fucked up. Silent Night. You know what I mean? What mm-hmm. kind of song? Is it about him getting made, or is it about? Is that? I don't know. Anyway, but I loved the part that sort of went under the radar during that set of, like, when you said, you know, everybody's all upset about Jesus getting killed or whatever.
Yeah. I love that. Yeah.
And I think it's important to, like, you know, always remember that some of the stuff that you're saying is going to be funny, but if you don't leave them a chance to know like that laugh. It's funny, because that's just a simple beat thing. Because, look, mm-hmm. I just got that laugh off of literally just saying something that you said. But a lot of people don't even notice it if you don't, you know. You just got to breathe sometimes, even though you only have 60 seconds and it's not easy.
Isn't that, Tony, isn't that like a, like a kind of a, I don't know, this is just comedy talk, but it's a fine line letting things breathe versus pacing. Because sometimes people will go too slow
right.
and sit, and it just sucks all the energy out of the
yep.
room. They'll say one line,
yep.
like, that's my big line,
yep.
and then wait 3 seconds, 4 seconds, and then it kind of, I don't know, it's a tricky thing.
And it changes, and it evolves continuously. So, you know, it's one of those things. I mean, it changes in a matter of 2 minutes. You could be 10 minutes into a 15-minute set, murdering, and you start going too fast, and you don't realize it until 20 seconds too late, and then they feel you make the adjustment. So it's one of those important things where, like, you know, a great classic note is just, like, listen to yourself while you're mm-hmm. performing. You know, listen through the speakers and not through your mouth, sort of, and to the audience.
Yeah.
Anyway, Well, and by the way, this is your last minute, so thanks you so much for being part of the show. It is sad.
Thank you.
You're moving on to new things. You're doing the road and very cool things like that.
I would really like to invite you next Wednesday to the Death Squad Secret Show in the main room.
Oh, cool.
For a full set.
Brett Morris.
Awesome. Cool, guys. Thank you.
There she goes,
so
Vanessa
much.
Johnson, ladies and gentlemen. And here you go. Let's shock the world. Mr. Nice Guy, we have 2 minutes left. After this, we're not even going to talk to him. We're not going to say a word to this guy, but we're going to give him a minute right now. Put your hands together for Brett Morris, ladies and gentlemen. Fine. You have a bunch of fucking angry people in the front. You win, Brett. You win, Brett.
Merry Christmas.
There you go. Brett Morris, everybody. There you go. Brett Morris.
How we doing? A little bit about myself. I'm 32, and I feel like as I'm getting older, I'm getting a lot more stickler for the rules. As an example, my friend on Facebook, he posted a pretty nasty picture of his cock on Facebook. So, I did what anybody would do. I reported him. It was made even worse is that he had six young chicks in the picture with his cock. Now, I don't care if he was working on a free-range farm raising chickens or not. The rules are the rules.
Boom! Brett Morris, you did it. There you go. That's our time. We got you up. We squeezed you in here. Brett Morris, there he goes.
Good job, buddy. Good job.
Come back more often. This is your first time doing stand-up? Very first time doing stand-up, Brett Morris.
Well, nice.
There it is.
Wow.
Brett Morris, ladies and gentlemen. Will you come back again? Do you live in L.A.?
Greatest place in the world.
Visiting from where?
Great job,
On your way to San Francisco. Are you living there now?
No.
Where do you live?
I live in South Florida.
South Florida. Fuck yeah. Well, there you go. Well, if we ever go to South Florida, you'll be on this show.
Don't ever leave.
Brett Morris. Jason Tebow has a new album coming out the second week of January. What's it called?
Return of the Red State, January 14th on All Things Records and iTunes.
And Steve Simone's album is out right now. One
of
the top sellers on all iTunes.
Yeah, it's called What's Up, Nerds.
What's Up, Nerds. That's what it is. I get them all confused. I remember back when you had no albums. Now you're like Katy Perry over here. Pat, what's up? What do you got?
Love you, Tony. Thank you for the time and creative freedom.
Thank you. He's at Patty Reagan on Twitter. Joel Jimenez is at Mostly Sorry. Brian Redband, we're going to San Francisco and Moon Tower. I'm also doing stand-up in a bunch of places. Calgary, Dallas, San Antonio. Corpus Christi and a lot of other fun places. Check out TonyHinchcliffe.com tomorrow when I put up new dates on TonyHinchcliffe.com.
I'll be at San Jose Friday, and we have a secret show next Wednesday here at the Comedy Store.
Live audience, thank you so much. Have a great night, everybody. Take care. Yeah.